Well, hello. June 26th, today I will... Well, yesterday was a strange day. I noticed my puppy outside was excited, staying on the end and keep looking up. So eventually I decided, okay, I will take a look why she's... What's she looking up for? Maybe I thought it was birds or something. And I go outside and I saw on top of that power pole, right next to my property from the neighbor, there was a raccoon up there. At least at first I just thought maybe a bird built a big nest. But then I realized that that's not true. There was a raccoon cowering up there. I assume my dog scared it. It didn't realize there was a fence in between. So it went up the next tree or whatever pole to protect himself from my dog. And my dog, of course, took on the challenge to keep it up there. So I was waiting and see if this would be self-regulating itself. That was around 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Well, the raccoon was up there at least 12 hours till midnight. Midnight and 12:30 at night, I decided to bring in the dog because I have outdoor lighting for the dog. So I brought in the dog to stay at least with me till the sun up, which is at this moment almost at 4 o'clock, 3:30, 4 o'clock. It's already sun up again. And I turned off the light, and then this morning, of course, around 5 o'clock, I let the dog out first. She went immediately looking for her enemy. But then I realized she calmed down, and I took my camera, because I have a hard time bending my head up to look that high. It's just in my age, it's not that easy anymore. I took the camera and I took the shot you will see in the end. The animal went down. It saved itself. Once the light came off, it became totally dark and it probably felt safe and secure. I'm relieved it's done. So that's good. Well, today is June 25th. Hello, puppy. And I noticed that my dog was looking up this pole, this flagpole in the middle there. Flagpole, the electric pole. Repeatedly. I'm sorry, my camera is moving funny. I broke the selfie stick, so I looked at it and I realized that somehow on top of that flagpole is a raccoon. Did you chase the raccoon up there? Did you chase him up there? The pole is not even on our land, so it's not on her side of the fence. Very, very strange, very weird. But if she is not down by this evening, I will try to keep the dog inside for quite a few hours to give this animal a chance to come down. At the moment, it seems to almost sleep up there. I went up to show you a better picture. I took my drone out and I flew around it. And I got near and then it actually woke up and looked at the drone a bit closer. Quite a fair size raccoon, I think. Well, there we go. I'm going up and you will see me trying out different positions. The first part of this drone video was taken by my Mavic Mini, but it was very windy, very gusty. So, and also I realized afterwards I should take another shot with the other drone I have, which is have a zoom possibility, the Mavic Zoom, Mavic 2 Zoom. So the second part you will see is done by the Mavic 2 Zoom. But this is quite a fair size raccoon, I believe. I don't know how it stayed up there for that long. It must have been up there a minimum of 12 hours, maybe a bit more. I don't know when my dog chased it up there. Maybe it was almost, because they move at night, so maybe it was up since the night before. However, this is strange. I have a few times since I'm here, some life forms. Even this year, I had two skunks visiting my dog, and she, thank God, she has the smarts enough to stay away from the producing end of the stink. She approaches it just from the front, so she missed the big whiff. She got some spray on her fur, but nothing that lasts more than 2-3 days, and then she's okay, so far. But, and the skunks, of course, by now I've learned their lesson to stay away. I had one porcupine pass through in the back of the property, not on our property, thank God, because that would be a bit more expensive if the dog runs into a porcupine, if she doesn't know how to handle it. I'm not sure what she had experiences in her 10-year life before. So I also, to a few years back, I remember a mama moose and a papa moose, mama moose and a baby moose walking right where the fence is to passing into the little forest behind where my car is parked right now. There was a bit further down, there was a black bear a few years back. The police had to guide out of here. I've heard from other people they had deer on their property. I have never seen a deer here, but there's a lot of salt licks. Well, this is the end of the drone video. So, I'm just coming down. Yeah, it's interesting stuff. Well, this is the morning after. I just wanted to take a look if the animal is still up there. She's gone, and I put in puppy around 12:30, and I kept her in till 3:30 for 3 hours and turned off the light so it was really dark, and the animal took this time to escape. That's great. Well, that was that. Thanks for watching. My only content this year so far. My second visitor in the Corona crisis. That was a raccoon. Talk about self-isolating brilliantly. That animal, you can cut a slice of his self-isolating skills. Ciao, guys.